A linear function has the form f of x equals ax plus b, where a and b are just constants, in other words, just numbers. For example, if I have f of x equals 2x plus 3, that would be a linear function where a is 2 and b is 3. Or if I have, let's say, f of x equals 5x, that's also a linear function. A is 5 and b is actually 0 because there is no b that you see. So if you wanted to, you could imagine like a big invisible 0 next to it. Another example would be f of x equals, let's say, 10. In this case, we don't see an ax part, so a must be 0 and b is just the constant 10. So all three of those examples are linear functions. A linear function's graph always graphs into a straight line. So for example, I could have the graph look like this, a straight line, or I could have the graph look like this, a straight line. I could have the line look like this, or maybe I could have the line look like that. So as long as it's a linear function, it'll graph into one of those straight lines. A linear function has an output that changes by a constant amount for each unit increase in the input. So remember inputs and outputs from functions before. Whatever input I give it, if I increase it by one unit, the output changes by a constant amount, is what it basically says. For example, a room is at 60 degrees Fahrenheit and the heater's turned on, and the temperature T is recorded each hour H. So they give us a little table of the hours being 0, that's the start of the time, and the temperature being 60 degrees. 1 hour later, we see that the temperature has risen to 62, 2 hours to 64, 3 hours later to 66. So if we had to guess what's happening, it looks like each hour that goes by, the temperature goes up by 2 degrees, and our guess would be that it reaches 68 degrees at the fourth minute. So what happened here was the x values, or the input values, went up by 1, and the output values consistently went up by 2 degrees. So it was a 2 degree increase per hour. This constant change is actually what a linear function defines. So the output changes by a constant amount for each unit of increase in the input, which is happening here in this example. So this seems to fit the definition of a linear function, therefore it must fit the model y equals ax plus b. So we're going to try to figure out what the equation of this linear function is from the table that they gave us. Now y is the output for us, I'm going to replace that with t, and x is the input for us, so I'm going to replace that guy with h. Now I just have to figure out what a and b are. Well, a is always going to be what's called the rate of change. So a is the rate of change. And that's basically that constant change that goes on for every unit increase of the input or the x value. And in this case, that rate of change is 2. Because every 1 hour, 2 degrees is what the temperature goes up by. And the b is basically what happens initially in this problem when we have the temperature being at 60 degrees at the start, when we just initially start counting time. So b is usually associated with the x coordinate being 0, and whatever that number is going to be our b value. So in this case, to begin with, the temperature was 60 degrees. So that was our b, which means the equation that fits this data is t equals 2h plus 60. Again, our output was y, I called it t, our input was h. I put that in for the x value, and the a is 2, and the b is 60 in this case. And I could test this out if I say h is equal to 4 for the fourth hour. Basically what happens, I can have t equals 2 times 4 hours later, plus 60, and that's going to give me the 68 degrees that we had guessed. If I were to graph the temperature over time, a quick sketch would be my horizontal axis, which has the hours, and then my vertical axis, which has the time. And I have gone and plotted the 4 points that we have from up above 0, 60, 162, 264, and 366. And again, I'm just doing a rough quick sketch. And as you can see, the temperature started at 60, and it's going to slowly rise and go up and up. And you can see that the dots appear to be linear and graph into a straight line. Let's say the temperature is at 60 degrees Fahrenheit and the heater is turned on, but it's broken. So we record the temperature and this is the table we get. What would be the temperature at the fourth minute? Well, if we were to guess, there's going to be no change whatsoever as I go from one to the next. So this, our guess would be that remains at 60 degrees. So no matter what happens, the time goes by, but the temperature stays constant. So if the temperature stays constant, meaning it doesn't change, this is a constant linear function. And a constant linear function basically has no a, or a is equal to zero. That means I have f of x equals just b, no change, no rate of change a, and in this case I will have t equals 60 degrees at all times. Or in function notation, I could say the input is h, so t of h is equal to 60 degrees, and no matter what h is, t is always going to be 60. T is always 60. That's what a constant function does. You give it an input, it doesn't care, it's always going to spit out the exact same thing. And if I were to graph it, a quick sketch, well, it's always going to stay at 60 degrees no matter what time it is or how many hours it is that's passing by.